In this video, let's take a look at how fast Algorand is and how fast Ethereum is. When talking about blockchain speed, you need to consider three metrics: TPS, block time, and time to finality. I'll explain what these mean later in the video. Now, before I continue, all of the metrics mentioned in this video are based on the latest data as of December 2023 and may change in the future due to protocol upgrades. All right, let's first take a look at TPS. TPS stands for transaction per second, so it shows how many transactions the blockchain can execute per second. Currently, Ethereum can handle about 15 to 30 transactions per second, while Algorand can handle up to 10,000 transactions per second. Let's now look at block time. Block time is the time it takes for a newly created block to be added to the blockchain. Now, many think this time equals the time for your transaction to get executed with absolute finality, but this is not true. The entire time it takes for a transaction to get executed with absolute finality includes the block time, along with the time for your transaction to get propagated throughout the network into the mempool, and also the time to finality. I'll explain these concepts more later in this video. Currently, Ethereum has a block time of approximately 12 seconds, while Algorand has a block time of approximately 3.4 seconds. In Q1 of 2024, the core developers of the Algorand protocol are aiming to bring the 3.4 second block time down to the 2-second range, making transactions on Algorand even faster. Last but not least, time to finality. Now, time to finality has a lot of different names, but in this video, I'm defining the term time to finality as the time it takes for the latest block added to the blockchain to become final. And when I say final, I mean all the transactions included in that block becomes irreversible. Many get confused here, so let's dive in a bit deeper to understand this concept. Depending on what consensus protocol a blockchain uses, some blockchains allow two blocks to be added to the blockchain at the same time. Now, this is called forking of the blockchain. When this happens, suddenly we have two different records of the blockchain, and the validators securing the blockchain must choose one chain that they think is the true chain. And as time goes by, more blocks will be added to both chains, and one chain will be considered the canonical chain, according to the fork choice algorithm. For Ethereum, it uses the LMD-Ghost fork choice algorithm. Now, if you want to learn more about this algorithm, I'll leave a link in the description to an article explaining how the algorithm works. Anyways, when one of the chains is selected as the canonical chain, the unchosen chain gets completely ignored, and all the transactions included in the shorter chain gets canceled. Now, since this forking is a possibility in a lot of the blockchains, including Ethereum, they usually recommend 6 or 7 blocks to go by to be 100% certain that the block including your transaction is final. And the time for 6 or 7 blocks to go by is time to finality. This is why time to finality is not 0 seconds for many blockchains. So, now that we understand what time to finality means, let's see what time to finality is for both chains. Ethereum's time to finality is about 1.5 minutes, as it recommends users to wait 6 or 7 blocks to be 100% certain that the block is final. So although Ethereum has a block time of 12 seconds, to execute a transaction and for that transaction to become irreversible, it takes about 1 minute and 30 seconds. Now on Algorand, the time to finality is 0 seconds, so Algorand has instant finality. In other words, all transactions sent on the Algorand blockchain, whether it's a simple payment transaction or a computationally heavy smart contract application call, all get executed with absolute finality in 3.4 seconds as long as the network is not congested. Of course, we have to count in the network propagation time, so it may take up to around 5 seconds, but the point is, the time to finality is instant, so the time for all these transactions to get executed is fixed, around 3 to 5 seconds. We call this instant finality, and it is one of the most powerful features that Algorand provides that developers can take advantage of. Whether it's a financial application or a consumer-facing application you're building, having the ease of mind of knowing that your transaction will always get executed and become irreversible in around 3.4 seconds is extremely helpful as a developer. Now, when talking about blockchain speed, we can't leave out transaction fees as it is highly correlated to how fast a chain is. In Ethereum, transaction fees, also called gas fees on Ethereum, are dynamic, meaning it can go up and down depending on how congested the blockchain is. Since Ethereum currently has a maximum of 30 TPS, if more than 30 transactions get sent per second to Ethereum, the transaction fees for those transactions will become more expensive. Also, gas fees differ based on the complexity of the transaction. So if the transaction is a computationally heavy smart contract call, the gas fee will be more expensive. It's also important to note that even if a transaction fails, the gas fee you paid for that failed transaction is not returned. So users have to worry about losing their transaction fees, hindering them from sending a lot of transactions. On Algorand, transaction fees are fixed to 0.001 algo, no matter how complex the transaction is. A simple payment transaction cost is 0.001 algo. A complex smart contract call is still 0.001 algo. However, there is an opcode limit for each transaction, so if a complex application call requires more opcode than the limit per transaction, you can group multiple transactions to cover the entire opcode budget. So if you need to group two transactions to execute an app call with high opcode budget, you will be paying 0.002 algo. Having a fixed transaction fee structure is beneficial for both business owners and users, as they can predict how much fees they will have to pay as operation cost or to use certain applications. Also, the fee is extremely cheap on Algorand, so it allows developers to build applications with great user experience. Now, the transaction fees do increase when the Algorand blockchain gets congested, but considering how it can handle 10,000 transactions per second, and considering that Visa handles around 1,700 transactions per second on average, that scenario is highly unlikely. Also, if a transaction fails due to lack of funds or smart contract conditions, the transaction fee you paid is returned to the sender, so users can comfortably send transactions without worrying about losing the transaction fee. So, to summarize, when looking at speed of a blockchain, you look at TPS, block time, and time to finality. Ethereum has 15 to 30 TPS with 12 second block time, and just over a minute for time to finality. And Algorand has 10,000 TPS with 3.4 second block time and instant finality.